Tapu and noa go together. It's like night and day. The sprinkling of water on our hands or on ourselves is removing those restrictions or that state of tapu into a state of noa, which is free from constrictions. It's just part of our tikanga that we carry. We just get some water. Whakanoa. And so that's the function of hine pū te hue, this piece here, the lifting of that tapu. I say it represents a hue or a gourd in Paka to embrace hine pū te hue. She is the goddess of the gourd and the sound and the goddess of peace. The first process in the construction is the acquisition of the stone. There's also the drawing up of it, the conceptual side of it. We block it out, we form it, and then a process of hammer dressing occurs, which I love because so many of the stone artifacts from different Polynesian kingdoms in this place have been hammer dressed, and they just formed ridges by continuous tapping, which symmetrically reduced surfaces so that they could attain what they needed to do in the form. It's a real zen sort of a space to get into. The physicality of the stonework is huge. It's a huge toll on your hands, on your sinews, on your hydraulics. But that's what I love. That's what I love about what I do. It's there's a mental challenge that goes with the hard graft. Hine pū te hue, when I first brought her in here, I was in work mode. And really, it was about placing her in here, getting all those, the plumbing and the water and the levels all right and everything. It wasn't until the next day when I woke up, I've washed off 6 months' work, and suddenly it hit me, holy heck, I've finished, you know. It was great. It was great. The process, there's a psychological process of letting go and of giving it away. Tikanga Māori seems to be oozing out of the wall and the floor in this place. So as mana whenua, when we look at the history of Tamaki Makaurau and the different iwi that have been here over the years and the mana whenua that is here, and then everyone comes, all the mana whenua come here to embellish this space, I would say it's extremely humbling, given the history and the layers of the land here and the history and the people and the artifacts that are in this building. Pretty amazing.